Must be the reason why I'm king of my castle. Must be the reason why I'm free in my trap zone.
Must be the reason why I'm king of my castle. Must be the reason why I'm making examples of you, 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 you.
Today's video, we're covering the all-new HGLRC Sector 132. Now, this is a 4K 3-inch Whoop, which is pretty interesting. However, there are some things you need to take note of before purchasing this. Now, first of all, let's start off with the execution here and some of the things they do provide you with. First of all, you get a 4K camera, which is the CADXTAR CR-V2. And for flight controller, ESC, and PDB, basically, you get their new Zeus board, which is everything into one board. And this is rocking 13-amp BLHeli S ESC. So, and again, the ESC, flight controller, on-screen display, which is the OSD, everything is built into one board here. Now, for motors, you're using the HGLRC motor. These are 1106 3800 kV, so 3800 kV. And this quadcopter runs both 3S and 4S, which is what I've tested it on a 450 milliamp, and I still got pretty good flight time. However, this is a 3-inch quadcopter, but in default, it comes with 2.5-inch propellers, so keep that in mind. And in order to put the 3-inch propellers, you are going to have to remove the prop guards here and set up these propellers. They do provide you with both propellers here. They give you Gemfan 2540s, and they also give you Gemfan 3035s. I've only tested it on the 2540s here, outdoors and indoors. Now, I'm not going to be able to show you the footage indoors because I was flying in a school. I was allowed to fly. However, I'm not allowed to share the footage. But what I can tell you is it flies really great indoors with this set. Really great, actually. Super stable. However, outdoors, when there's some wind, it flies not so great, and you kind of want to avoid that. So you want a very calm day, and or its main use is for indoors. I mean, it's really quiet too. It's actually quite impressive how quiet this thing is compared to the other ones. So that's something I really like. Now, if we come back to the execution here, we see they've added low ESR capacitor in the back here, which is a must, especially when everything is on one board. And don't forget, these are 13 amp ESCs, which should handle just about everything you throw at it, because it's not a speed demon. It's not meant to go fast. It's just meant to capture great shots. Now, for the video transmitter, it's back here on a 20 by 20 setup. Now, this thing is up to 400 milliwatts. It does have pit mode, and its input voltage is 5 volts. So keep that in mind. And you do also have smart audio, which you'll be able to directly modify through your on-screen display to change channels and everything of that nature. For receiver, you get the XM Plus, and I think you get a FlySky receiver, and it's just very well properly executed. And for the antenna, they also even provide you the antenna, which again is really great, and the anti-slip battery pad here. Now, I think this is the first time I've ever got to test the CADXTAR CR-V2, and I might say that I am preferring still the Runcam Split 3. I think you just get better quality video. I did record everything on 2.6K 60 frames per second, and it just felt that the edges were blurry. You don't blame HGLRC, it's more of a CADX thing here. But I still actually prefer the Runcam Split 3, in my opinion. That's, I think, by far one of the best split cameras that have been made. This is my opinion. Everybody else can have their own opinion, but for me personally, I still love the Runcam Split 3. So how did this thing fly? Well, indoors it flew great. And again, I've only tested it on 3S because I had no 4S that would fit this. And it flew pretty good. However, I didn't attach a GoPro, even though they do provide you with the GoPro stuff. And they even give you the 3D mount if you're going to put a DJI Air unit inside, which is really nice that they've done that. Now, on a 4S, it probably handles a much, much better outside. But on a 3S with slight wind, it wasn't doing so great. I really had to keep fighting it most of the time to just keep it, just to have it keep its position, but not fighting it to keep it in the air. Those are two separate things. So I did have to constantly fight it because the wind was really rocking this around and I couldn't really get stable shot. And again, it's really windy, and that was the best day that we got in order for me to fly. So it's not a conclusive test in my opinion. However, the indoor flight footage, and again, I can't show it to you, but it was phenomenal. I really did enjoy it. I got some nice shots, but I'm not allowed to share them, which I won't, so I don't ruin the place that I usually fly in or the school that I usually fly in now. Now, once the weather clears up, I am planning on removing the prop guards and also setting up the 3-inch propellers and picking up some 4S lipos just to see how well that's going to run. I think it'll fly really great outside once you remove this stuff. But again, the default setup out of the box when you get this is mainly aimed for indoor use. You do get pretty good flight time. It is on the efficient side. I would say you'd get around 4 minutes of flight time on a 450 milliamp 3S normal lipo, not HV. On an HV 300 milliamp, like the ones that come with the Happy model and stuff, you can get around 3 minutes of flight time. That was outdoors for me. Indoors was around the same thing, actually. 3.5 minutes, 3 minutes, 15 seconds. It all depends on your flying, but you are able to get a good flight time. You're not going to just fly for a minute and a half and have to land. Now, if we grab a closer look at the frame here, what we see is we have the top plate being 2.5 millimeters thick and the bottom plate being around 3.5 millimeters thick, which is okay. And what we see is we don't have any sharp edges, which is really great. This will improve the overall structural integrity here. Nice to see. And I really like the fact that this thing takes both a 20 by 20, 16 by 16, and as well back here, we see that it could take 20 by 20 stacks and as well as 16 by 16 stacks. So that's really nice to have here. I think one of the first quadcopters actually do this right now. So you can take a double stack between a 2020 and a 16 by 16, which is pretty interesting. And well, there's really nothing else to say other than it works and it just flies good indoors. And I'll have everything linked down below. Let me know what you guys think down in the comment section. And I'll be picking up more of these later on and we'll be testing them. Hopefully the weather starts clearing up very soon and I'll be able to go fly again. And I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out, guys.